In one of my previous videos, I talk about my evening ritual. I highly recommend checking it out before watching this video because the success of a morning ritual depends on the flawless execution of an evening ritual. Now with that out of the way, let's talk about why I believe a morning ritual is essential. Several successful people attribute their success to their morning rituals. For example, Tim Cook, CEO of Apple, Michelle Obama, First Lady, Jack Dorsey, CEO of Twitter and Square, Richard Branson, founder and chairman of Virgin Group, Howard Schultz, CEO of Starbucks. Surely they must be onto something. Now, even if you don't believe that to be true, waking up earlier makes you more healthy, more energetic, more positive, and less stressed. Who wouldn't want that? Now, keep in mind that the day doesn't start when you wake up. It starts even before you sleep. You need to have a good sleep and good preparations the night before in order to have a successful morning ritual. Okay, let's get onto my morning ritual. I divide my morning ritual into 5 sections. Section 1, the morning mindless. I like to call this the morning mindless because there is absolutely no thinking required in order to do these steps. The first step is to shut off the alarm. This should be pretty straightforward, but there's a caveat. No snoozing is allowed. This forces me to wake up on the clock. In addition, this forces me the night before to set the alarm for exactly the right time that I target to wake up, and I'm not allowed to deviate from it. Because if I do, then I will probably sleep and forget to wake up after all. I have to be intentional with my sleep and commit to the sleeping time, as well as when I stop sleeping. If I have a feeling that I'm not going to wake up on time, I shouldn't force myself to wake up on time, because if I snooze, that extra quality of sleep that you get snoozing isn't really real sleep. So I might as well just, you know, set my alarm later and wake up later. That's okay, you know, it happens sometimes. But I need to be intentional with it, and that is why I do not allow snoozing. I would go so far to say that snooze is the worst invention ever made. It just encourages procrastination. You are procrastinating when you hit snooze. You're like, nah, I'll do it later. But then when you do it once, you're going to want to do it twice, and you're going to want to do it 3 times, and you're just never going to want to stop. So yeah, procrastination. Snooze. Bad, bad, bad. After I shut off the alarm, I'll proceed to go use the restroom. You know, my body's been asleep for a couple of hours, and now I'm at the mercy of my biology. The next step for me is to weigh myself. I customize this step for myself because I like to collect my health stats, because I maintain what I like to call a personal scoreboard. Hopefully I'll get around to it one day to make a video about my personal scoreboard. But in short, it's really just a way for me to collect objective data so that way I take out any of the subjectivity that I and my own bias inflict on myself. This allows me to measure myself better and more realistically. It's part of my quest to know thyself. After I weigh myself, I'll proceed to put on my workout clothes. If you remember from my evening ritual, in one of my preparation steps, I lay out and prepare my workout clothes the night before. So that way this morning, I just gotta go to my morning basket and collect it and just put it on. Super simple, I don't have to think about it, I don't have to fumble to be like, oh, where is it? Where do I leave it? No, it's just all there for me right away. The next step for me is to drink some water. Again, this is also part of my evening ritual where I do some preparation beforehand. I have a water bottle that is fully topped off. Again, no more need to fumble, no more need to grab my water bottle, fill it with water. No, I could just drink it right away. That is the power of preparation, guys. It's so essential and such a life changer. Finally, the last step as part of my morning mindless is just to walk out of my bedroom. And the reason I do this is because I don't want to be tempted by my bed to go back into sleep again, to go under the covers. No. I know that I am going to succumb to that if I stay in my bedroom, and that's why I leave. I remove that temptation away so that way it's not even there. After I finish my morning mindless, it's time for me to dive into the section about spiritual engagement. I believe in the need to reaffirm your identity on a daily basis. This can mean different things to different people. For me, since I identify as an evangelical Christian, that means reading a book of the Bible every day and writing my reflections on BibleReadingDaily.com. I will also pray and give thanks to God that I've been given another day. The next section is mental stimulation. Okay, cool, so now I'm out of bed, my soul is alive, now it's time to wake up my brain. The way I like to do this is I like to read. I'll read a book. Maybe if I have some extra time, I'll read some online articles that I've bookmarked, or even a Medium article. If I read about something particularly interesting and intriguing, I might even spend some time to really think through it carefully. The rule for myself during this time is to avoid anything about current events or the news, because I am not yet ready to invite the world in. This is still my own little personal time, and I don't want anyone to distract me from it. The next section is physical exercise. Now that my brain is awake, it's time to stimulate my metabolism and get the blood flowing through my entire body. Time to go work out. My workout is pretty simple but holistic. I don't use any equipment, I don't go to the gym or anything like that, and honestly, I'm not really a fan of gyms because you pay to exercise. That just doesn't really make sense to me. Exercising should be free, just like the air we breathe. My simple workout consists of cardio, pull, push, core, and legs. In other words, more specifically, this would be 2 mile jog as cardio, 4 sets of 5 pull-ups as pull, 4 sets of 15 push-ups as push, 4 sets of 30 leg raises for core, and 4 sets of 15 squats as legs. No equipment required other than that pull-up bar in the park that I use to do my pull-ups. After I finish working out, I move on to my favorite section of my morning ritual, deep work. This is the part of my morning ritual that I treat as the most precious, because this is time where I can do some work without any distractions or interruptions from anyone. And we know just how hard it is in this day to get some nice peace and quiet. Deep work is focused work that is becoming increasingly rare in today's era of constant distractions. The term was made popular by Cal Newport when he wrote his book, Deep Work. In my case, deep work involves writing on my blog, maybe writing my YouTube script that I'm going to film for the day, and so forth. But it could really be anything, depending on if my hobbies change or if my interests change. Like, for example, someday I might go play the piano or even write some music. Point is, no one is here to distract you to say stop or to interrupt you or anything like that. It's all your time. Finally, this is my time to get ready for the rest of my day. I'll go ahead and take a shower, brush my teeth, get dressed, get ready for the day, and lastly, I'll open the blinds. This signals to me that my morning ritual is complete. I can now start the day knowing full well that I had an amazingly, gloriously productive morning. I've taken care of all my needs, I don't have to scramble or anything like that or go out in a hurry. I can go out and face the rest of my day with calm and confidence. Quick recap. My morning ritual consists of 5 different sections. The first section is the morning mindless, when I do a series of mindless tasks right after I get out of bed. Next is spiritual engagement to fill my soul. Once that is done, I need to stimulate my brain or turn on my brain. After that, I'll go get some physical exercise to get the blood flowing through my veins. And finally, I'll perform deep work, any type of work that I want to do for myself without any distractions or interruptions. By the end of my morning ritual, I am out of bed, my soul is alive, my brain is active, my body is energized, and I've performed deep work. I'm already ahead in my day before it even begins. Implementing a morning ritual is one of the best decisions I've made in my life. Now, I feel in full control of my day. I've done this for about a year now, and I can definitely positively say that it was totally worth it. If you'd like to read about this, I actually wrote about this in one of my blog posts. Just head over to jerry.blog and you'll see this post, along with a series of other posts that hopefully you'll find interesting as well. I'll put the link to the description below. Question for you: what are your thoughts on my morning ritual? Do you have a morning ritual? And if so, what does your morning ritual look like? Post in the comments down below and I'll be sure to read them and respond. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you enjoyed this video, please smash that like button and consider subscribing as well. Let me know what else you'd like me to cover. I'll see you next time.